you. Thank you so much. Glad to be here. I've been getting back to nature lately. Well, I was evicted from my parents' house. I'm the youngest of three. I always got hand-me-downs and secondhand smoke. And none of my siblings like to sleep. I don't like to sleep either. I was up all night last night reading a book about insomnia. Other insomniacs here may be too tired to raise your hand. Oh, I'm such an insomniac. Sometimes in the middle of the night, I like to go out. I like to go to Walgreens or Rite Aid or CVS, because they're open 24 hours. They have to be. Their employees are so fucking slow. I'd be tired too if I had to work that late, though. So, but I'm an insomniac, and I couldn't sleep at all recently. I was in Alaska. I was in Alaska for 3 days and six nights. And, I stayed at the One Season, and I got. It was so cold there, you guys. I saw a dog wearing a cat. And I knew it was a preppy dog because it just had the paws tied around its neck. But I don't know about you. I hate being cold. I can't wait for global warming. I am. I mean, not really, of course, right? But I like being hot. I like sweating. I like sweating, but I don't like to exercise. So I like a sauna or a really good audit. Because that'll make me sweat, right? But you know what else makes me sweat? Flying. I hate to fly. I don't know if you know this, but it costs $2,200 to smoke on a plane, I found out. I don't smoke anymore. I quit smoking because I got scared, you guys, because this woman came up to me. She was like, Miss, your cigarette, it's bothering me. And I'm thinking to myself, well, obviously I don't give a shit about me. Why would I care about you? But it got me thinking that basically we're all on one big plane, right? And I better start giving a shit. So I better start going green, right? Right? So I got an American Express card. No. I didn't know what going green meant, so I wrote down the definition, and I'm gonna read it to you now because I wanted to be precise, so I wrote it down. It's going green is adapting your lifestyle so you do less damage to the environment, Wendy Liebman. That's what it said. And then it said 5 things that I could do to make myself do less damage. I could recycle, right? Does regifting count? Going out with old boyfriends? This is recycled, by the way. This is my rejection letter from college. I wanted to go to Brown. Actually, it's a wait list. I was waitlisted. I'm still waiting. I went to Wellesley College. I like to refer to it as IOU because I majored in English because I'm also a writer. I write. They're mostly Czechs. They're not very good. They mostly fiction, but they're paperless. So recycle. I have a recycled dog. I just got a used dog. It's a rescue dog in case I get stuck in a well. It's my first dog. He's 6 years old. He's 20 pounds overweight. He's a Chihuahua. He's so smart though. He marks his territory, but he uses traffic cones. And then they tell you the other thing you could do to reduce your, or to help the environment, you could use public transportation. Yeah. In LA. Ew. The last time I was on a bus, some really nice guy offered me a seat in his lap. Use public transportation. Do taxis count? Taxis? Anybody? I drove a taxi for 2 months. I never picked anybody up. I just needed a car. Now I have a car. I have a hybrid. It's half sedan, half clunker. And it gets really good gas mileage because it doesn't really start a lot. But gas is so expensive, isn't it? Yes, it's so expensive. Sometimes I just go up to the pump and the attendant comes out and he goes, can I help you? And I'm like, just browsing. I can't believe I'm going to tell you this, but I lost my virginity in a carpool. You're supposed to carpool. That's good for the environment, right? Hey, if your astrological sign is a Gemini, you know, the twins, right? Can you drive in the carpool lane? No? Okay, my cousin, actually, she asked me if twins were the result of a multiple orgasm. I'm like... She just got one of those electric cars, yeah. And 1,000 extension cords. I hope she bought them local, because that's the other thing you could do. You could buy local. That helps the environment. Buy local. Like, go to your farmer's market, right? But then you have to eat all healthy and everything. Actually, when I eat healthier, I have to say, I feel so much hungrier. And weaker. And a little gassy. But no. I eat mostly raw, you guys, because I don't know how to cook. Although on Thanksgiving I cooked just recently. I made a 23-pound turkey pot pie. I know, that was a bitch to stuff into my George Foreman grill. I had you're supposed to remodel your house, too, to help the environment. Remodel. I didn't even model it, but I recently saw somebody moving their house. Yeah, there was a house and it was on a truck. They were moving a house. I'm thinking to myself, are these people too lazy to pack? Because it was a house, it was coming right at me in my lane. I'm like freaking out. I'm like flashing my brights, beeping my horn. Nobody was home. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what to do. My heart was pounding, right? So I thought fast. I pulled into the garage and I sat there and... But the lights were on. Nobody was home. You're supposed to reduce your energy usage. That's what they say. That's the last thing they tell you, is turn things off at night. And my husband says I do that all the time. Actually, lately, my husband's been asking me to bring another woman home. Yeah. Not for sex, for cooking. Probably for sex, too. That's a lot of guys' fantasy, right? Yeah, two women. I don't even like three-way calling. I don't want another woman in the room when I'm having sex with my husband. I don't even want to be in the room. So anyway, I'm going to try to do all of these things. I'm going to recycle, right? I'm going to use public transportation. Maybe buy local, remodel my house, and cut down my energy use. But before that, I'm going to go to sleep. Thank you very much for listening.